Welcome to this virtual worship service within the sanctuary of the First Congregational Church in Williamsburg, Massachusetts, on this Christmas Eve. We are delighted that you are with us, and we pray that your spirits may be lifted as we journey into the Christmas season during this time of our families and friends being physically apart because of the COVID. Even if we cannot gather in person,
Emmanuel, God is with us.
Even if some Christian traditions have had to go,
Emmanuel, God is with us.
Even if we must not hug family or friends,
Emmanuel, God is with us.
Even if we cannot sing carols beside each other,
Emmanuel, God is with us.
Even with masks on our faces, our eyes can smile.
Emmanuel, God is with us.
Even with all these things we dare not do this year,
we still can worship God who is within us.
Tonight, we relight the four Advent candles on this wreath and name them again.
The first candle is hope.
The second candle is peace.
Love. accessible. So I light the Christ candle in the center of our wreath. Now, as we think about what God's coming means to each one of us,
and the prospective parents are throwing what they call gender reveal parties. This trend apparently started in 2008 when a mother-to-be posted a picture of her and her husband cutting a cake with pink icing on it, revealing the gender of their in utero baby. It went viral, and since then people have competed to see who could come up with the wildest gender reveal. People have batted pinatas filled with pink or blue powder. One family had a crop duster dust the field with 350 gallons of pink water, and the plane crashed. Another father-to-be caused a 47,000-acre wildfire when he shot his own hunting rifle into a target filled with blue powder. And others have used all sorts of pyrotechnics, some far less safely than others. All this so the baby shower clothes would be the right colors. Now, I'm not making any of this up. You can't make it up. It's all over social media. However, the announcement of Jesus' birth took place in a much more quiet, obscure place. But the baby reveal of Jesus as Savior of the world is nothing less than theological dynamite. We will soon hear the familiar story of Jesus' birth as told by the Apostle Luke. Maybe the story is too familiar, so familiar that we miss what is actually being a more explosive reveal than anyone might create in their own backyard. God's reveal wasn't a party, nor was it a media event. This reveal takes place in some very quiet places. Through the words of the ancient prophets, in the quiet of a tiny house in a nowhere town of Nazareth, to a teenage girl who was engaged to be married, on to lowly shepherds sleeping in the fields near a little town of Bethlehem. The angel tells the shepherds that this baby would grow up to be the Savior of the world, who was the Messiah of the Lord, and he would be found in Bethlehem. And this reveal was not just, it's a boy. It's an announcement about his purpose. It is a reveal that God has broken into a broken world in the form of a leaky, burpy, crying, tiny human child. It revealed that this baby, born of the Holy Spirit and of Mary, fully human and fully divine, would forever redefine humanity. Indeed, the real reveal of Christmas is that in the coming of Jesus, God has rebuilt the human race. And this is the good news of Christmas. It is the good news that it doesn't matter who you are or where you came from, what your past looks like, or what bad decisions you have made in your life, and what hurts and brokennesses have happened in your life. Christ has come to offer you a new beginning. All you have to do is let his grace and life catch fire within you. The Savior of the world has been revealed and laid in a bed of straw in a manger. His coming, humanity, and divine purpose were revealed centuries before by prophets like Isaiah, who celebrated him, the Savior, named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. And this Savior reveals to us how we too can be revealed as people made new by the grace of his love. Now that is definitely a reveal to celebrate. No explosives necessary. Amen.
Our Christmas Eve scripture reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 to 20. And I'm reading from King James. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David. To be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into the heavens, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told concerning this child. And all that had heard this, wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Father, help us remember the birth of Jesus, that we may share in a song of the angels, the gladness of the shepherds, and the worship of the wise men. Close the door of hate and open the doors of love all over the world. Let kindness come with every gift and good desires with every greeting. Deliver us from evil by the blessings which Christ brings, and teach us to be merry with clean hearts. May the Christmas morning make us happy to be thy children, and the Christmas evening bring us to our beds with grateful thoughts, forgiving and forgiven. For Jesus' sake. Amen.
Christmas. May everybody say, Happy Christmas.